All right, so I want to take you back to way back when. How did you and Kelly meet in the first place?
We met 13 years ago. We met at a trade show. It's called ASR in San Diego. And at the time, me and my sisters were working for Roxy, which is the female counterpart of Quiksilver. And he was at the Quiksilver booth, and he was in town for the contest at Trestles. And the booths were across from each other, and I just looked over. And it's funny, I had worked with the company for years and years, and he had ridden for Quiksilver for, by the end of it, 23 years. And we had never crossed paths, never seen each other, anything. And so it was funny that far in to see each other. And yeah, we actually celebrated our 12-year anniversary. And we were talking about when we first met, or like the first time we saw each other. But I remember exactly seeing him for the first time, and time really did stop, so.
So then what was did he ask you out on a date for the first time, or how did it?
No, we were just friends, and then I remember he was finally like, oh, I'm in love with you. And I was like, I mean, I think I knew deep down, probably, but then I was just not sure and confused, and then I remember he actually got on a plane to go to France. When he landed, I was like, oh my God, what am I doing? I was like, I want to come, book me a ticket, let's go, let's do this. So we like technically had our first date in France.
What do you like about him?
It's rare to find someone who loves what they do so much. And I've always said that, and he loves surfing. Like at the end of the day, surfing comes ahead of everything else, and he just really loves it. And I love how passionate he is about it, and always trying to get better. Always, I can always see his mind just working away. And I like that. And I like how he's so gracious, still takes the time to talk to everyone and say thank you for coming. And like, he's such a good host.
So what's the typical schedule like for you guys?
It's very last minute. Everything, Kelly, there's something called Kelly time.
What's Kelly time?
Kelly time is always like 5 minutes late. A little delayed, but it's always kind of just last minute. So whether we're making plans or anything, you have to be able to drop everything and just go.
Okay, so give me an example of that.
Like I have no idea what we're doing tonight or tomorrow or the next day. There's a kind of a general schedule that we keep to.
So you could be boarding a plane to some other part of the world tomorrow?
Or he would go because he'd see a swell, or he'd say, oh, I really want to go to Fiji for a couple days, or I want to go pop over to Hawaii and check on the house. I don't know. Yeah, anything. He actually this year will spend more time out of the country than in. He actually left at the beginning of the year to go to New Zealand and then Australia, and traveled all around Australia, then Bali, then back to Australia. Then he went to South Africa, straight to Brazil, or Brazil straight to South Africa, came home for a couple days. I think he went to Florida maybe for a day in there.
All right, so how about marriage and kids?
Did you ask him about that?
I have not, no.
I don't know, hopefully one day.
Yeah.
We're both so busy right now. So yeah, hopefully one day, definitely. I'm from a family of four, he's from a family of three. Now when I see people traveling with four kids, I can't imagine my family or anyone doing that. It's crazy. I don't know, maybe two or three.
You think you'd have to wait till he called it quits from World Surf League?
Maybe. Yeah, I think it'd be hard for him to, I don't know, because it would be interesting to see him try to balance both of those things and whatever, having to put his competitive nature aside for a second to put the baby first. Yeah, I think it'd be interesting.